The final use case for breakout rooms is, let's say you want to have private office hours. I mean, you can have office hours in this room and students come in, they meet with you, but it might be they don't want to say something in the main room where everyone can hear it. So what I would normally suggest is that I have a slide in the main room to kind of create an actual little waiting room and set the expectations. Now, what you write might be slightly different. All I did is create a PowerPoint slide and import it in as a file, and now I'm sharing that on the main screen. So it welcomes them to the office hours and sets my expectations. So I want them to say hi in the chat so I know who got there first. When people say hi in the chat, it puts them in order. So if I had four students join around the same time, I'm not going to wonder, wait, who should I be meeting with next? No, I'll look at the chat and see who I should meet with next. And now what I'm going to do is use breakout rooms again. So go back out, go to breakout rooms. I'm going to use a custom assignment again. In this case, I don't want to enable people to be able to switch groups because I don't want someone dropping into a private area. And finally, what I'm going to do is, let's say Mark, I know he wants to meet with me privately. Well, I'll drag him into group one, and then I'll move myself, the instructor, into group one as well. When I click start, now me and that student are going to be in a private room where we can chat, we can share our files, we can share our screen, and nobody else is seeing what's going on. Once we're done meeting, I'd go back to that breakout room area. And what I'm going to do is, presumably Mark might leave when he's done, but if not, I'll take him, drag him back to the main room. And now maybe Mark 2 is the one who's told me in the chat he wants to meet with me privately and meet with me next. Fine, I'll grab Mark 2, drag him into group 1, and click update. And of course, if I needed to, I could bring in more than one student. But this is switching who I'm meeting with privately. And really, that's the various use cases you could use for the breakout rooms.